So hi students, today we have Manoj with us. He is, I think officially you are the highest package holder of all the students of RVM CAD. He got a package of 9 lakhs, 9 or 9.5?
9 lakhs plus 50,000 bonus.
Plus joining bonus. So he got a package of 9 lakhs from RVM CAD as a CAD designer, and he did AutoCAD and NX CAD from RVM CAD, and he also got sweets, and it's his birthday also today. So happy birthday also.
Thank
to you.
You.
So please tell me about yourself, like a little bit about your profile, what you were working as.
So initially I was working in a small firm like Unique Inc. So it's a fabrication company, and they are vendors to Toyota and Kia Motors.
Unique Inc.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they also do special purpose jobs
okay.
for other industries.
Mm. Mm.
And I gained my production knowledge and quality knowledge. And I used to put some effort in design as well.
So you are basically, you're an engineer, right?
Yeah, mechanical.
Where did you do engineering from?
I did my engineering from Cambridge Institute of Technology.
Cambridge Institute.
Yeah.
In which year did you pass out?
2016.
16. 16 ke baad, what did you do after that?
So I took up a 1 year gap to prepare for my GATE.
Okay, exams. GATE you took a 1 year gap.
Yes.
Okay, so you how many attempts?
No, just one attempt, and I didn't have much time, so I took up a job later on. So that was directly into Unique Inc.
Okay, how did you get this job?
It was a small referral, you could say, just a word, a mouth word referral.
Okay,
and
you got into quality.
No, it's a engineer position, so I had to be in all the fields. It's a small industry, so I had to take care of production, quality, as well as some basic designs.
Okay,
okay, and. Later on, I worked there for around 2 years, managing the products from raw material procurement to dispatch.
Okay.
And I got an opportunity with Viro Metal.
Viro Metal?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a sheet metal fabrication company.
Mm.
And their customers are ABB, Schneider, and JCI.
So this was a tire 2 company?
Yeah.
They're providing the tire 1.
Yeah.
Okay. Yahan pe, what did you do?
So they took me as a quality assurance engineer. Basically, all the documentation related to quality, like work instructions.
Okay.
Pareto charts, implementing 7QC tools, and quality review meetings, all such documentations, and I would also take care of the in process and cosmetic finishes. And I learned I gained most of my knowledge there.
Well, how many years did you work?
I worked there for 3 years.
3 years.
Yeah.
Okay. So what was the, and this is the last company that you worked
at? No, after that.
Okay, changed again.
Yeah. Huh. After 3 years, totally 6 years of experience. So by then I had completed 5 years. At Viro Metal, I mean, wholly.
Yeah.
And later on, I got an opportunity with Mukunda Foods. So they are a food tech machinery company.
Okay.
Basically the same role what I had to do.
Quality.
Viro Metal. Yeah, Viro Metal, same role I was doing in Mukunda Foods as well.
Okay.
So my interest was in design, like from my engineering days. So I started using some basic design tools and implementing small changes.
Like AutoCAD?
AutoCAD, yes, in SolidWorks, especially during my initial stage, like Unique Inc. So I wanted to change my field.
So what was the salary in the last company that you were working at?
I was drawing around 30,000 in hand.
Okay. Okay.
So, and I took up my course here in RVM.
How did you get to know about us?
Again, there on social media, YouTube.
Okay.
That was helpful. And one of my vendor of Mukunda Foods. He's in Pune, a small company named Blue Star. So a person from there suggested me there's an institute. I got to know, started researching about
it. And you did with software here?
AutoCAD and UGNX.
UGNX, yes. Okay. So how much time did it take you to complete? Because you already knew a little bit of
yes.
Software.
So that helped me. I was working on it also by myself before I could join. So it took me around 3 months.
3 months to complete AutoCAD and NX. Okay. So now coming to the point about his new job. So where is this company? And I want to know everything about the hiring process so that our future students can also, you know, learn from it. And a lot of students in the north are from quality, just like you, 5 years, 6 years of experience. So how did you justify them to the company that you know something about design? Because in design, you're a fresher. You can say like in design, you're a new person.
Yes.
So how did you crack the interview?
So, basically, you should not put something fake in your resume and try to blabber in the interview. Whatever you know, even I couldn't answer most of the questions. Like, if I don't know, I was frank with them and they were okay with that.
Okay.
But at the end, I gave a positive note, like saying that I will put my effort.
You will learn it.
Yeah, I will try to learn it to
how did you get this job? Let's start from the very beginning. Like, how did you get this information about the job?
No, there's no particular information. I was trying to aim for any manufacturing sector.
Okay.
So something like where I'll be involved in design as well as my quality skills can
quality
be used.
Quality skills can be used.
But somehow I ended up landing in this job because it was everything was on the same platform. So like Naukri, Indeed.
Naukri basically. Yes. That's what, because see, a lot of my students are dependent on us.
Yes.
RVM will get them a job.
Yes, yes.
And we are doing our best.
Yes.
But I need them to do something on their own also. Yes. Na? Like there are so many ways in which they can help themselves. So basically from Naukri.com you got this job post.
Yes.
Okay. Any other platforms you use actively to get a job?
Indeed.
Indeed. Not LinkedIn?
LinkedIn also, sorry.
LinkedIn also. Yeah. Okay. So Naukri, you got the job, then they called you for the interview. How many rounds were there?
First round was just like HR round. They wanted to know about my skills and if my profile matches the job.
Okay.
And later on, the first round was like technical round.
Okay. I think we didn't tell which company you got.
So I got into Applied Materials and it's a semiconductor manufacturing based manufacturing.
Applied
company.
Materials.
Yes.
Okay. So technical questions. What kind of questions did they ask you that you could not answer? Like what were these kind of questions?
Something related more to most of design theoretically, like GD&T
questions.
Yes,
okay.
Not in the like basic level we could answer.
Yeah,
but in the higher end, it was like quite tough for me.
Okay, so GD&T is that important that even for a salary of 15,000 to we can say 9 lakhs, GD&T they ask everywhere.
Yes,
yeah,
and even it will be good if they prepare with the welding symbols.
Welding symbols.
And in one of my interview, not this but another interview, they had also asked. The power and the parameters required for a weld, like depending on
that's
the sheet thickness.
Theoretical, very technical.
So all these will come into consideration during the interview.
Okay.
And basically, my quality skills also helped me. Like I told them how I could implement the quality tools like 7QC tools, Pareto charts.
Yeah.
So they go deep into it once you start.
Once you mention then something, because you will see even someone in a 12th class background, ITI background, they write 7S. And, but once you ask them, they're like, we don't know.
Yes.
So that's why I said write only whatever you can answer.
Yes.
Otherwise, they will grill you on that and then it will be a problem.
Yes. So all these were like cumulatively. I used to work even in a little in Adobe Photoshop and everything. So
Photoshop also they asked.
Yeah, like it was given in the JD, but they didn't ask any question particularly regarding it.
Did they take any practical test of NXCAD?
No, like just a small tool test to just check if it is if I could do the models.
Okay,
so that was five.
That was done. Okay. So basically two rounds. One is the HR, other is the technical round in this company.
The technical round was online. Again, there was a direct round.
Okay.
After that, the salary discussion.
Salary
totally of 4 rounds.
All right. So, did they offer some lower salary before and then you negotiated, or was it the first salary that you accepted?
No, it was they directly offered me around 8 lakhs. But I pulled them to 9 lakhs.
How did you do that?
So, I negotiated with them. I had some offers, some other offers.
Okay.
So,
okay.
I told them if it would motivate me more if they give me a better offer.
Yeah. Okay.
And the packages were actually good at Applied Materials. Since I went through one of your videos, I checked it using the tool which you had shared.
Which tool?
To check the salary.
Salary? Oh, you saw that video.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So I uploaded the salary guide in which it tells you what package you can expect. So it's good that but in mechanical it's interesting to note that in 3 years nothing is given there. Like don't expect anything in mechanicals from 3 to 5 years. After that you can.
Yes.
Yeah. So that the initial time is a little bit slow. But anyway, any other companies you gave interview at, or this is the?
I had opportunities, but the salary was comparatively very low.
Comparatively low.
So okay, I didn't go to it.
Okay. So what are your future plans after this? Any other like you? Want to explore yourself only in design, or you also want to go for simulation and things like that in the future?
Simulation depends on the future, like growth, what the market is requires, and I want
simulation will help you for sure later on, not now. After like 2-3 years of experience in pure CAD, then it will help you a lot.
I want to go check on my job role, how will it be, and do some additional courses.
Yes. Okay, great. So congratulations again.
Thank you, sir.
And we wish you all the best.
Thank you.
And keep us updated, and if you have any other vacancies in this company, let us know so that more students can be placed.
Sure.
Thank you.